This is like a life coaching session with Indy.
It's Nick Short's BB Remix, and this is where I'll explore the social dynamic of Big Brother through videos and shorts. I capture live footage between the house guests before "You Are Not Allowed to Talk About Production" comes over the loudspeaker. Each week, look for brand new videos, so make sure you subscribe to my channel so you'll be the first to know when I upload a new video, and be sure to comment to say hello.
You need to change. You need to call her and...
Well, I know, I will call her, yeah.
And feeling bad won't fix anything.
Like, yeah. So send me her number, I'll call her right now. I'll get that. We'll do it.
Like, it's not enough, like, and we talked about, and you already say sorry.
Yeah.
And it's not like I'm not here to push you to do anything, but feeling bad won't change the world. We need to do something in every single aspect in our lives.
Like, we're not gonna let Patrick, we're not gonna let Patrick girl go.
At this point, I don't give a fuck, because guess what? CBS came up with that line.
Like, she literally Patrick walks everywhere she goes. Like, yesterday, she was in the storage room, she's like... let's run it back. This is literally the casual. It's like a bent over back thing.
Oh,
yeah. Like,
oh my gosh. You gotta add this. It's like a... Oh, she walls.
Okay. I'm going to be super fucking honest. And I might get my ass in trouble from CBS, but at this point, I don't give a fuck, because guess what? CBS came up with that line. They wanted to continue this narrative, and they wanted to continue for me to.
Internet's breaking. Your internet's bad, baby.
Is it bad? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
So you're saying that a lot of things came on your DR section.
Yes, the DR did provoke a lot of things, and they did formulate a lot of times lines.
I see that, like, but I always stand up for what I believed on my DRs.
And I should have. That's it. That's, you're right. That's it.
I always stand up. Like, they never force me to do anything. They never.
No, of course, they don't force.
Like, okay, we're gonna let's go on this way. How do you like this person? How you dislike? And I always, like, I just don't connect with this person. If you see my DRs about Taylor, it's like I just don't connect with her deeply. So I don't know what it is. And of course, I was not trying to connect. Yeah. And with my biggest regret on the game is that I didn't try. I didn't put all the girls together and knowing, like, okay, the DR may push you, but you had the right and the wrong. Like,
you're right. I did have the right to say no. For me, I was like, oh, that's kind of a good TV line for good TV, you know. But for me,
your face out there, and you knew that we signed up the contract.
No, I get that, and you're correct.
Fuck, it's my face here, honey. And, like, you're gonna make me say something that I don't mean it. So.
Yeah.
It's kind of tricky, and I see, like what you're saying, but
yeah,
we are, like, you're 22, you know how to say no already.
I'm gonna be just really honest with you, and you know what, people may really, like, not understand, but I was diagnosed afterwards with bipolar disorder. I went through a mania, I went through a manic episode, and you know what, for the people understanding that, that is when you lose touch with reality, and I was diagnosed with a fucking disorder, okay? So as much as I fucking wanted to stay in there, like, as much as I wanted to stay, I couldn't fucking stay.
I don't to make my baby, and I appreciate that you were sharing this.
Like, I couldn't stay. I wanted to stay. I'm sorry to the casting producers. I'm sorry to Big Brother. I wanted to stay, but I couldn't fucking stay. And when I came out of there, I was pinned as a fucking villain, okay?
I get it, and sharing your experience, sharing your mental health, sharing your diagnostic, like, everything can help other people, but you only can reach people if you open your heart.
And my heart is open, Indy.
Yes. Okay. ask people on Twitter, they're gonna send you the clips about things that you say, hate us and they push us and blah 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 and blah 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 blah. But we can use that in a good way. We can use that on that, okay.
To reflect, to self-reflect.
Reflection. It's like, if you see it this way, what I'm doing or what I'm not doing, that's think that about me.
I mean, she weight shamed Jasmine. Like, she weight shamed her. And Jasmine will, truthfully say that. Like, she'll come out and say it. She was the people. Like, she was very rude for her to say something mean. And then me.
Exactly what I'm saying. We all say things that that is not okay, and we all need to go back and see. Like, I cannot count on people to say sorry to me, but I can do my part.
Right.
Like, if I say something about you, even telling you, like, oh, you were talking a lot of shit, I don't appreciate that I say that to you.
No. Yeah.
Because that's not the Indy that I want to be, and I'm sorry for that because I put you in a position that, like, oh my gosh, like, she's judging the way that I'm talking, how much I'm talking. And that game is an individual game. I shouldn't be focused on you. I shouldn't be focused on me.
Yeah. And
what I see is, like, somehow, whatever happened, set the tone about how we saw Taylor after you left.
Yeah.
Left. The whole house started, like, okay, most of the house. We start, like, blaming her for something that, oh my gosh, P is not.
That's not okay. The Daniel thing was not okay. Like, when I saw that, that was so sad for me because he's using my mental health to pin himself against someone else. And
I don't see, like, he's using it. Is we only know so much in the house. When she did, like, the soup with me, and I was, like, so angry because I was hungry and I couldn't eat and blah, 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 blah. And I was like, I was so upset with her. I talk shit about her behind her back. Then I grabbed her and I talked in front of her face.
I did tell her, like, some of the things you've said have, like, rubbed me the wrong way, and you've rubbed me the wrong way. So I was a little upset. But to the point where did I say, like, you're a bitch to her face? No. So
I grabbed her and I was like, I say this and this behind your back, and I'm sorry. But that's the way I feel right now. How do you feel? Let me see. Explain to me where you're coming from. Oh, I'm just doing the, I didn't think about, it was just a comment. I'm like, okay, so I'm sorry that literally, like, dragged me to a place that I don't want to be, like angry during your 6 days, because I was worried about how your parents would see and taking care of you. Like, okay, her parents is probably going nuts at home.
No, I know. That's what happened. I mean, they did.
Yes. And then I was like, and the same thing with Taylor, like, think about how her mom and how her grandma felt, like, about, like, all of us. I'm not pulling anyone out.
Yeah.
Not trying to like her, not trying to spend time with her. I got to spend time with her the last week. My Brazilian friends got cuts of you saying things, excluding me. They got cuts about, like, you saying, oh, she's Brazilian. Oh, she's doing this because she's Brazilian. And, like, oh, she doesn't know. That was hurtful for me to hear. And I adore you. And I don't take that personally. And I know you have, like, your mental health going on. You had, like...
I was just saying, it was, like, a barrier, like a language. Like, sometimes things were a barrier in as far as, like, language. That's what I meant. I didn't mean it to, like, offend you. You know, like some things, some phrases, like I even some phrases, like in different language, like I wouldn't understand, you know? So I was trying to defend you, if anything. And, like, I was always looking for your best interest. And if I did say something, like, hurtful, I didn't mean it, you know?
Yes. No, I know. I don't take things personally, but
I mean to be malicious, like, or mean.
When I came out of the house, all that I want to know, we was checking on you. And my, like, no, you're not checking on her. Not now. You need to watch this first. And I was like, no, I don't care what she said.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I still think, like, she's part of this team. We are 16. I want us to have fun and be together and help each other.
Yeah. Then
Taylor got the big prize. Yes, we got the lesson. What are we going to do with the lesson? Show each other, like, how, okay, that's the way that I see things. How do you see it?
It's like, to understand medically what I went through, like, I don't think you under, like, it's gonna be, it's tough, you know. I just want to say that, like, it's something where your mind is not thinking correctly. You are high as fuck. Like, you are so high. Dopamine, when it spikes super, super hard, you're gonna say some crazy shit because you're not well in the head. And that's what happened to me, you know, like.
But you are getting treatment now, right?
Yes, of course. I'm on so much, like, I will show you all my medication. I have to take 4 pills every single day at night. And you know what? People can shit on me and say I'm a crazy person. At least I got fucking help, you know?
Like, no, getting help, that's important. But I mean, like, how you have, how is your mind right now about whatever happened?
My mind is totally out of closure in the sense that the people that love me will love me, and the people that hate me will always hate me. And that's okay. And I'm okay with that, you know? And I sent Taylor a DM. She posted something like, I haven't heard an apology from Paloma, because it's been extremely hard to deal with this whole thing, the negative constantly in my brain. The people in my DMs, like, I have hundreds of DMs of people every single day. You should die. Go die, bitch. You're a fucking piece of shit.
Like, that to me as well. Like, yeah, like, a lot of.
But yeah. For me, I finally did apologize. And yes, I did apologize to her. I sent her a message. And whether she opens that and sees it or not, like, I sent her a DM, you know? But I did my dues and I apologize. I did.
I still love you. Whenever you want to come over, come over. My house is open for you and for all of the other players. Like,
yours.